Hello all, welcome to Lucid Means. Today we will look onto the issue between the Election Commission and the Mizoram government. Even though the elections are over by now, the issue didn't settle well. So first we will check why this came in news. On December 2018, the Election Commission directed the Mizoram government to remove the Home Principal Secretary of Mizoram, Mr. Lal Nun Mavia Chuango, on charges of interfering with the poll process. This was done when the Election Commission received a letter from the Chief Electoral Officer of Mizoram, Mr. S.B. Shashank, mentioning an active role played by the State Home Department in this interference. Mr. Chuango was handling the revision of electoral rolls related to the Riang or Bru refugees who are presently in relief camps in Tripura. A group of influential NGOs asked Mr. Shashank to leave Mizoram for his role in transferring a Mizo tribal IAS officer, that is Mr. Chuango, out of the Home Department. The Chief Minister of Mizoram, Mr. Lal Tanhaula, has written to the Central Home Minister, Mr. Rajnath Singh, demanding the reinstatement of Mr. Chuango as the Principal Home Secretary. To ensure the smooth conduct of the Assembly elections, the Election Commission replaced Mr. Shashank and appointed Mr. Anish Kundra, a 1996 batch IAS officer, as the new Chief Electoral Officer of Mizoram. So, what is the issue? Disagreement between Mr. Shashank and Mr. Chuango was mainly on two issues. First one was about the deployment of CRPF in Mizoram. The Principal Secretary asked clarification to the Chief Electoral Officer on the deployment of Central Reserve Police Force or the CRPF in the state. But legally, Election Commission or the Chief Electoral Officers are under no obligation to consult the state governments on such matters. Second was related to the voting rights of the Riang or Bru tribes living in the Tribura relief camps, who are actually voters in Mizoram polls. That is, a letter from Mr. Chuango to Mr. Shashank said that the identification slips issued during November 2016 to the Riang and Bru migrants who are now living in the Tribura refugee camps should be used solely for the purpose of repatriation and rehabilitation and shall not be used for any other purposes. With this letter, the Election Commission felt that the state government is not keen to have new Bru voters enrolled to the voters list. So, who are these Bru voters? Riang or Bru are one of the 21 scheduled tribes living in Tribura. They are the second most populous tribe in Tribura after the Triburi tribe. They may also be found in Mizoram, Assam, Manipur and Bangladesh. The majority of the Riang belongs to the Vaishnav school of Hinduism and they claim the Kshatriya status. Buizu is the most popular festival of Riang tribes. They speak the Riang dialect of the Kok Burok language, which is of Tibeto-Burmese origin and is locally referred to as Kaubru. They fled to Mizoram in the wake of some ethnic violence in 1990s. Among the 30,000 odd Bru people who are living in Tripura right now, around 11,000 of them are registered as voters in Mizoram. The Central Home Ministry in July announced that a repatriation agreement has been signed between the governments of Mizoram, Tripura and the Mizoram Bru Displaced People's Forum. Now we will briefly look at the Election Commission of India. The Election Commission of India is a permanent and independent body established by the Constitution of India directly to ensure free and fair elections in the country. Article 324 of the Indian Constitution provides that the power of superintendence, direction and control of elections to Parliament, state legislatures, the office of the President of India and the office of the Vice President of India shall be vested in the Election Commission. The Election Commission shall consist of the Chief Election Commissioner and such number of other commissioners, if any, as the President may fix from time to time. Today, the Commission has three commissioners. The appointment of the Chief Election Commissioner and other commissioners shall be made by the President of India. The conditions of service and tenure of the Office of the Election Commissioner and the Regional Commissioners shall also be determined by the President. Today, they hold office for a term of 6 years or until they attain the age of 65 years, whichever is earlier. The Election Commission is assisted by Deputy Election Commissioners. They are drawn from the civil services and are appointed by the Commission with a tenure system. They are assisted by the secretaries, joint secretaries, deputy secretaries and under secretaries posted in the Secretariat of the Commission. At the state level, the Election Commission is assisted by the Chief Electoral Officer, who is appointed by the Chief Election Commissioner in consultation with the state government. That point is really important, that is the consultation with the state government. At the district level, the district collector acts as the district returning officer, and he or she appoints returning officers for every constituency in the district and presiding officers for the polling booth in the constituency. So, what is the process for replacing a chief electoral officer? The Election Commission is the authority which appoints or replaces the chief electoral officer. The Election Commission does this in consultation with the state governments concerned. In August, when Election Commission replaced the chief electoral officer of Rajasthan, its statement mentioned that this followed consultations with the Rajasthan government. Here in this case also, the Election Commission has followed the standard drill and asked the Mizoram Chief Secretary for a list of suitable candidates, and from this Mr. Ashish was appointed. So, as a conclusion note, the decision of the Chief Electoral Officer made the government and the civil society turn around. Here the people protested, and to settle the dispute amicably, the Election Commission transferred the officer. In a society, government and people should reciprocate, and the government should ensure that no further controversies arise with respect to the election process before the polls. That's all, and thanks for watching.